On the left side here, we have a box labeled source, which we can think of as our raw data file, maybe a CSV, or in this case, a JSON file called myData. And as we go through the pipeline of the grammar of graphics, we can think of it as applying a different transformation to each step, going from source to variables to algebra and so forth until we render the final graphic on a web page. In D3's case, the renderer is simply the web browser, and the browser displays the final graphic in the form of a web page. Going from a JSON source file, in this case, mydata.json, into what the grammar of graphics calls variables is implemented by D3's data loading functions, specifically D3.json if loading a JSON file. When called with a data file, D3 makes an AJAX request to load whatever your data file is, in this case, mydata.json, and turns it into an array of JavaScript objects. I don't want to get too hung up on the specifics of each stage of this grammar of graphics pipeline, or try to relate them to D3 functions that we may not have encountered yet, such as nest, scale, and layout, but I did want to cover some of the more common D3 functionality and how it relates to the grammar of graphics. In this pipeline, once we have our JavaScript array of JavaScript object literals, nest is a function that I encourage you to look up, but it simply groups our data. D3.scale transforms a continuous or a categorical variable into something that a web page can display, such as a pixel value or a color. The D3 layout function is a convenience function that allows us to apply a common transformation according to a set of predefined chart layouts we might want, such as a pie chart, a histogram, or a graph. .append in D3 is what actually inserts our SVG or HTML elements, which we've already seen. In this case, .append rect puts rectangle SVG elements for every data point. .attr changes some attribute of whatever we're appending. In this case, rectangle.attrx changes where we want to position our rectangle, its x coordinate, and specify the value where we want to position it. And last but not least, we can control the aesthetics of our visualization either through D3 and specifying attributes on the style, or by using CSS selectors and CSS specification to, in this case, fill our rectangle with a green color.